Next we have insurance. Insurance is insurance premium here, which you pay annually for getting insurance coverage for your assets. So it is a example of nominal account expense, therefore we say it shows debit balance. Next item after insurance is your drawings. Drawings is opposite of capital, so drawings shows debit balance. Next that comes to an end, the third problem. Moving on to fourth problem, we have fuel. So fuel is the materials what you use to generate power, so it represents expense, therefore debit balance. Then you have in the same freight. Freight is nothing but carriage inward. Freight is nothing but carriage inward, which is expense, therefore debit balance. So you can say carriage inward shows debit balance. Next is interest received. So interest is nominal account received. Word is saying it is an income. So you know incomes show credit balances. Next is bad debts. Bad debts is representing the amount which the people who purchased from you goods on credit, they have to give you money. So if they don't give you money, it represents a loss to you. So because losses come under nominal, it shows debit balance. Next, that is about fourth problem. Moving on to fifth problem, you have one item which is slightly different from the rest of the other problems, that is miscellaneous receipts. This miscellaneous receipts will be taken as your income, and you know incomes show credit balances, so I'm taking it as credit. Now moving on to sixth problem, you have premises. Premises is nothing but your buildings, etc. So since they are assets, they represent or they show debit balances. Next, in the same problem, you have reserve for bad debts. This any reserve always shows credit balance, so remember. Moving on to seventh problem, we have provision for doubtful debts. Provision for doubtful or bad debts. Provision for bad debts or doubtful debts. Sometimes it will be given as doubtful debt. So this show credit balance, remember. Next you have goodwill. So this goodwill is called as an intangible asset. In the beginning chapters we discussed, because it is an asset, it shows debit balance. Same with patents. So patents are also examples of your intangible assets, so they therefore show debit balance. Next you have loan from SBI. So you know that loan means you have taken from SBI, therefore it represents a liability, so it shows credit balance. Next, in the same problem, you have legal expenses. Though the word clearly mentions expenses, they are nominal, so you take it as debit balance. Next you have prepaid expense. So we discussed already, prepaid expenses are personal accounts, so they show debit balance. Next we have outstanding salary. So you have to pay the amount. So when you have to pay the amount, it is still a liability. So liabilities show credit balance, outstanding salaries therefore shows credit balance. Now next you have discount on purchases. Discount on purchases, it is nothing but discount received. Discount on purchases is nothing but discount received. You know it's a gain. It shows credit balance. Then you have discount on sales, nothing but discount allowed. So it shows being a loss, it shows debit balance. It shows debit balance. Now the next item is provision for depreciation. We know that all provisions should credit balance. So provision for depreciation, it shows credit balance. Next, you have your general reserve. General reserve, all because being a reserve, you know it shows credit balance. Applying this, you can complete the rest of the problems on your own.